Give me a few minutes of your time and I will give you all of the information you need to lose weight and keep the weight off for good. Stay tuned for this video. Hey booze, welcome back to my channel and welcome to my channel if you are new. If you are new, hello, my name is Keisha. Make sure you hit that subscribe button if you would like to see more content like this. Also, hit that post notification bell so you'll be notified every time I post, as well as following me on my socials at Keisha Rose 2. And go into the description box down below after you're done watching this video. That way you can find out everything you need to know about me, my weight loss journey, as well as getting some weight loss inspiration and motivation for yourself to start your own weight loss journey. You guys, I'm excited for this video today. I'm going to be letting you guys in on my 50 pounds. And I know I say 40 pounds in the title. I really lost 40 pounds in 1 month. This is my recent weight loss journey. You guys have no idea about this. I'm about to show y'all videos and everything. You guys are about to get in on something that I just been holding to myself and why I've been doing it as well. If you want to get straight to the tips, fast forward to the number that you see right here. But if you want to get into the nitty gritty about my journey, watch this part of the video. So, after my BBL, I gained back weight. I tipped the scale at 202 pounds and, I went on a weight loss journey. And like you guys know, I can do this weight loss thing in my sleep, but it was something different this time. I wanted to go into my mind and figure out why it was I was doing this. I wanted to figure it out. I wanted to kind of like master it in my mind. So therefore, I can come back and tell you guys how to do it and what I did and different things like that. I didn't want to share it at that time. I just wanted to hold it into myself for a minute. But I went on a weight loss journey and within a month, I was 40 pounds down. And by the tipping into the second month, that's when I was 50 pounds down. And the reason I did not share this is because, like I said, I wanted to figure out why. But what I did this time was I know that when you have purpose and a reason for something, it sustains you a lot more. So I knew I wanted to lose weight. I knew I wanted to lose weight, but my reasoning wasn't enough. So it's funny how in life, us as human beings, we care about ourselves enough to not to go out and commit the S word and just off ourselves, right? But we don't care enough about ourselves to not put things in our mouth that we know that are unhealthy for us, and not to overeat. And we see high blood pressure, diabetes and stuff like that. We care enough about ourselves not to do that, but we don't care enough about ourselves not to do stuff like that. When in turn, you are doing the same thing to yourself. But this over here, overeating and stuff, is the same process. It's a slower process, but you will get the same end result if you don't get it together. You see what I'm saying? You're going to wind up in the dirt no matter what if you don't get your life together. So it's so funny. I wanted to dive deep and really care about myself. I've been super heavy. It's dust flying, you guys. I've been super heavy on the self-love. It's crazy. And at this time, because I did the work in my mind first, I did the work there. This weight loss, the weight that I've lost, I don't even desire to overeat anymore, you guys. I have no desire to overeat. I don't care about overstuffing myself and different things like that. I look at food in a different way. That's why lately I've been talking about intuitive eating. And I'm just super excited that I did that for myself. So many people be coming in the comments, why are you showing the pictures before the surgery and this and this and that? Bam, there you go. I literally went on a weight loss journey again. And I'm super confident keeping it off this time, you guys. And I, like I said, this is going to be a series of videos and I am going to be telling you guys how I did it, starting here first with the calories and all of that stuff. So I want to get straight into some tips for you guys. I know that was a lot and I'm sorry, but I just wanted to let you guys in on what I did. But like I said, I feel good. I feel mentally good. I feel mentally strong. That's why I can come on these videos to you guys now and tell you, look, if you ain't got it right here, you have to have the right mentality. You have to want this because you want to live and be healthy and live a healthy quality life. If you don't have that in your mind, if you cannot penetrate that through your subconscious by telling yourself that over and over again, even if you don't believe it until you believe it, you ain't got nothing. If you don't want to be healthy, if you don't love yourself enough to be healthy, you have zilch, nada. Okay. And that's what I had to figure out. We think we love ourselves a lot and all of this stuff, but we don't love, if you are picking up food, overeating and high blood pressure, fat, sick, unhealthy, you don't love yourself enough if you're not on a journey to get better. If you're just sitting there in your misery, you don't love yourself enough to, you don't love yourself enough to change that. That's how I look at it, okay? And that's what's keeping me going this time around. I ain't trying to overeat. I ain't trying to do none of that. I am eating to live, not living to eat. So let's get into these tips, you guys. And these are just a couple of quick tips to get you started on your journey, if that's what you want to do, is get started on a journey. So let me get my phone in my hand. What you want to start off with doing first and foremost is figuring out calories. Calories, calories, calories is so important, because if you're not in a deficit, you are not doing it right at all. Unless you're an intuitive eater, and 9 times out of 10, if you're an intuitive eater, you are not going to be heavy in the first place. So if you're watching this video, 9 times out of 10, you're not an intuitive eater. You need to count them calories. So you guys see here, I'm just going to a random BMR calculator in my phone, Googling it. And right here, it says enter the age. And this is absolutely free. You should not be paying for this. It's asking me my age. I hit in 34, asking me my height. I'm 5'2", asking me my weight. I'm about 150 on a good day, 155, even 157 sometimes on a overly full day. Anyway, so I put 155, and then you guys can see right there, this is if I'm doing nothing at all, 1522 calories. And this is just to function on a daily basis, right? This is just, if I'm not a person who work out, if I'm not a person who does nothing but pretty much sit on the couch, this is how many calories that I need to function. And then you go down, you can see it breaks it down to you. If you little to no exercise, you need 1827. Exercise 1 to 2 times a week. I mean, 1 to 2 times a week, 2093, and yada, 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 on and on and on. You guys can see that on the screen. So I am about, I'm intense exercise, I would say 6 to 7 days a week, right? Sometimes. So let's just take that number you guys see over there in the calories, 2626 a day. I just had a brain freeze. I'm sorry. 2626, that's per day. So now I'm going to go into my calculator, and here you guys see, it says that I need 2626 a day. So I'm going to take 2626 and times that by 7. And so I have 18,382 calories, but I'm just going to say 18,000 calories, right? So this is how much I need to maintain my healthy working out if I want to stay the weight that I am. Not lose, not gain, but if I want to stay the weight that I am, right? So what I did is I had 1200 calories a day, right? So I have 1200 calories a day. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to times that by 7, because I want to get in a deficit. So you guys see that they said I needed 1800 to maintain my weight. So what I did was I want to lose some weight. So I have 8,400 calories right here on the screen that you guys see, right? So that's in a whole week. So what I did was you take 18,000 calories and you minus 8,400. So I put myself in a deficit of 9,600 calories, and even a little more, because you guys see I just rounded it up to 18,000 calories. So when you do this, you're going to lose weight without a doubt in your sleep. This is something that is not debatable. Calorie deficit is not debatable when it comes down to weight loss. So don't let anyone tell you that it is. It's non-debatable. So when I did that, I started literally losing weight by the day. And if you do this, you'll lose weight by the day as well. As long as your body is in good health, If you get a little bit of working out in, I don't care if you're not working out, you're still going to lose weight if you're eating 1200 calories a day. Now, when you work out, you're just boosting yourself to lose weight even at a better rate. Like I said, I don't look at working out as a vehicle to lose weight. I look at it as a vehicle to get my heart healthy, my mind right, anxiety and all of that. But when you do marry the two, you get awesome, awesome results. So that's with the calories. If you're not in a deficit, you're not doing it right. And the next thing that I did, and most of you guys who watch this already know that I intermittent fast. And if you're not familiar with intermittent fasting, what intermittent fasting is, you're in a window of eating. You eat for a period of time, you don't eat for a period of time. And I did 16-8. You eat for 8 hours throughout the day and you fast for 16 hours throughout the time, even including your sleep. So you're just not fasting for 18 hours throughout, you know, this includes you being asleep. So don't get scared and think you're going to starve to death or something like that. So the thing with intermittent fasting, what a lot of people don't realize is it boosts your body to prime fat burning mode, right? So if you eat at your last meal at night, and then you eat, say for instance, your last meal was at 8 o'clock at night, then you don't eat again until about 12 o'clock or 1 o'clock the next day. And then you worked out, even if you don't work out, if you're sitting on the couch and a couch potato, your body has digested that food. Your body digests your food 6 hours after you eat, right? So your body has digested that food. So what your body doing now is, I don't have no food. I don't have no food. What am I going to do? Bam, your body taps into those fat stores. That's all over your body. All that fat, that's all over your body. It taps into those stores and begin to burn. So you know how people talk about keto, how people lose weight super fast on keto. What you're doing is you're putting your body into ketosis temporarily, in something like ketosis temporarily. It's not okay to be in ketosis for a long period of time. You'll get sick like that. Your liver, kidneys, it's not good for your body, right? So you're putting your body in it for a short period of time and your body is burning all of that fat that's all over your body. Not to mention, intermittent fasting, it ups the human growth hormone and you start to look younger. You start to feel younger. Your body starts to lean out a lot more and you just is in the best position to burn that fat. So, and that's just a little bit of what intermittent fasting does for your body. So you can do a lot more research on that. I have videos all over down below that you guys can check it out and find out about intermittent fasting. And a couple of other things that I just want to hit on really quick, is just healthier habits. You know what I'm saying? Drink more water throughout the day. You don't want to be a dehydrated human being. That's the worst thing that you can do for yourself. Drinking water helps you, especially when it comes down to you intermittent fasting. When you get hungry, you have to get, and another thing, you have to be okay with feeling hungry. You have to be okay with that, because what that's doing is shrinking your stomach. The more you eat, the bigger you're pushing out your stomach and making your stomach bigger. So if you want to shrink that stomach, you need to be okay with being hungry at times. And you're putting yourself into a position to where your body starts to rely on its natural instinct. Eat when you're hungry, stop when you're not. That's what it's about. So yeah, healthier habits, drink that water when you're hungry. I guarantee you it'll help you. It'll help that hunger to go away temporarily. And then when it's time to eat, bam, you didn't eat. Work out as well. Get some working out in, get some movement in. That way it'll get that heart. I guarantee you if you're here and you're overweight, a lot of times you're suffering from anxiety probably. That's because you need to be moving. You don't need to be just sitting down all day at your desk or on your couch. Get up and get your body to moving. In the morning, go on a walk in your living room while you're watching some TV. If you're at work and you can't stand up and just move for about 15 minutes, just a little walking. You don't have to do a lot. Your body does not require a lot. Your body does not require a lot. Just pay it little tips, and in turn, your body will pay you back. You see what I'm saying? Give your body a little something and your body will give you something back. All right, you guys, this is not rocket science. It's simple. Remember that.